body falling down cooler 闇へ but never going back 立ち向かえどうせ高く上げて Now dive ボンドなんてもうグッバイショックにもなくファイナルカマゾン See to the another day I wanna know it from my sin no more どこまでも上がってこう Hello YouTube, I'm back again with another video. I'm going to be talking about this woman who scammed on GoFundMe pretending that she has cancer. And although this occurred a year ago and she was like 19 at the time, her name was Madison Russo. She did get arrested. And I do want to bring this up. Yes, you can actually be convicted of lying about your condition as well as trying to make profit because you were basically scamming and scheming people online in order to benefit, especially if you're being dishonest and like leading misinformation. And usually if you're trying to run a business, you always want to make sure it is confirmed that you are actually undergoing treatment and that you are suffering from the illness. And one thing I do know, and again, this is surprising, I said this before in my previous videos, the people that were donating to her were easily convinced and manipulated. Yeah, you could say some are victims, they had some sort of sympathy, but a lot of it is because they were deceived by her looks. And that, to me, is like, it just goes back to what I'm saying. And then, like, again, you don't have to, I'm not saying you have to be bald in order to have cancer, but I would, looking at this photo, I would think there is something odd about it. Like, and even they're showing you, like how the tape itself is not even in the right it's not in the right pressure point. And although I don't have cancer, I wouldn't know what's like, because I personally, I don't want any tube inside me. You have to know where you like exactly where to stick the tube. But she's claiming she has like leukemia, whatever, that she's suffering and that she really needs that money in order to gain proper treatment, in order to like help her, and that she has pancreatic cancer. Sorry, my lisp over the years. Saying claiming it's the size of a tumor, and that's literally how much money she made. But my thing is though, how come Boogie didn't get arrested for this? Considering it's been proven that he's guilty, although there may have not been enough proof at the time. At the same time, I feel like people need to really dig deeper with Boogie, not just him, but anybody that's lying about their illness, and to prove how much. And of course, it is still ongoing. We are going to go straight to the court case. So let us proceed, you guys. And yes, you guys, you can tell she's in court giving out her statement for like her actions. And look, judging from the impact statement, it's just her being a complete narcissist, not wanting to hold herself accountable and take responsibility. And in a way, it's like you cannot ever like try to have a civilized conversation or want to hear this person out. Because again, it's just them trying to play victim. And what is the point in even trying to like cooperate with this person if they're not willing to oblige with you and just accept responsibility and just like be able to like realize the extent of their actions? Because it's like like, sorry doesn't cut it. I'm the type of person, like, I'm not gonna give you a second chance unless I know you've redeemed yourself and you've been reformed. And in order for you to be able to redeem yourself, you have to be able to, like, pay for your actions, depending on the extent of your, like, of your deeds, whatever the consequence may be, and how much you gotta be able to, like, endure it. So there really is no best solution in trying to forgive and forget, because we need to see for ourselves if that person can actually just accept what they did and just try to be able to, like, improve themselves. You can't take back, you literally can't take back everything that you did. So you might as well show how, like, what you can do to owe the people that you've wronged. Because at the end of the day, you guys, those who are on GoFundMe, and unfortunately for those who might have cancer, whether it may be breast cancer, leukemia, pancreatic cancer, it makes people with those actual conditions look terrible. It makes them look worse, if anything, simply because nowadays people feel like they'll be easily deceived, and then they really see no point actually giving out money from all the past, like, scams that's been going on, and it's especially being exposed online. So people are really trying to be wise and be more cautious, and which in actuality should, which they should do. And I do want to say for a fact that because it is very irritating, is that I mentioned it before, is that you, of course, you have idiots, especially, I understand people trying to be nice, and the thought is what counts the most, but there are people who are just donating simply because they find that person appealing. Based nowadays, like I said, people playing favorites will do whatever they can to be able to offer them in order to get their attention. So whether someone, again, there's not really much I can say to try and persuade those people. I'm not trying to do that. I'm just trying to expose the stupidity that goes on in the internet, as well as people who just let themselves get played easily, and which I'm glad I'm not in that category. But if anything, look, I'm glad I'm not the shoes. Let them suffer for it, you guys, because they're always gonna fall for the trap if they keep being too generous and being too naive, just because they easily get deceived by someone's like appeal at the end of the day, which honestly should never really be the case, you guys. It's all about having common sense. And clearly, from what I heard from Russo, Madison Russo, she's just trying to come up with a scapegoat. She's literally just trying to be a scapegoat here so that we can all forget and just move on. And that's not how it works. The only way we can ever move on is you're able to repay your debts. And it doesn't seem like it, because she's still at the end of the day gonna have to face jail time. That's what she really fears, is going to jail. But at the same time, it's deserved, and it's much needed. In order for her to really, like, reevaluate herself and be able to rethink her decisions, and maybe not decide to, like, continue on that path, and then probably most likely gonna be forced to swallow her own pride, just accept that I don't want to go to jail again. I want to be able to start fresh and hopefully do the best I can so that people can perceive me as a, like, trustworthy person, which will probably take some time, but it all depends if she can be able to, like, figure it out herself and show how much she's able to adapt and just, like, forget about the things she did and hope to regain her honor. That's just really is, like, at the end of the day, it's going to be stuck by you because it's all on the news, on social media. And that's the thing, though, when you're on social media and you're being exposed for something heinous, something malicious, something insignificant and harmful, yeah, it's gonna affect your entire life while you're alive, as long as you live. So you gotta do the best you can to actually be able to live your life. So, which you might not be able to do that, because it's already posted on the internet, and she can try to forget and try to do the best she can to make something out of herself. But how can you? People are just gonna keep judging you. So, and which I don't blame, because she took that path, but it's just better to move on and try to think of all the positive you can to basically reevaluate and develop yourself. But she still needs to go to jail. And I said the same thing. I'm surprised Boogie hasn't got that treatment yet, but eventually his time will come soon. But I feel like I said enough, you guys. Hopefully you guys enjoyed the video. Be sure to check for more upcoming content in the future. Be sure to check your notifications. Comment, like, subscribe. Thank you.